Time Series Insight is coming with a bunch of updates, and we have Shipra from the TSI team here to tell us all about it, all the way from UX enhancements to integration into Power BI. That's today on the IoT Show. Hi, everyone. You're watching the Internet of Things show. I'm Olivier, your host. And today we are talking about Time Series Insights and what's new in there. Shipra, thanks for joining the IT show today.
Thank you for having me, Olivier. Thank you.
So tell us a bit about yourself before we jump into the topic. Who are you? Which team are you working for? And what are you doing in that team?
I am Shipra Mishra, and I work for Azure Time Series Insights team. I'm a product manager on that team, and I work on the infrastructure part of it. Yes.
Awesome. So we had Chandrika and other people on the show ready to talk a bit about Time Series Insights, introduce things. What you came in to talk about is the new features, the additions to Time Series Insights. The service is growing. It's actually listening to our customers and their feedback. We're adding new features, new functionality. So what are the main things that are coming in that refresh of the TSI preview?
Yes, we are very excited about all the new features that we are going to showcase for Time Series Insights. There are four main ones. I'll start with the biggest one that we are going to support. The first one is we are going to support Warm Store and TSI.
Mm-hmm.
We have a lot of UX enhancements in our Explorer.
Okay.
Then we have added support for discrete variables.
Okay. We'll talk about that, exactly what that is. Okay.
Yes. And then the last one is now we support Power BI Connector, so you can actually export your data.
Awesome. So we'll see how that works and what the reason is for having these kind of connectors. Let's talk about the first one. What's going on with Warm Storage? What is it? How is it needed? Why is it needed? And what is it that developers will benefit from?
Yes, yeah, so we have heard a lot from our customers. Right now, the current SKUs that we have, customers have to pay for query.
Mm-hmm.
And it kind of does not work as well for dashboarding-like scenarios,
yeah,
where you have to pay for query and you want to refresh your data every minute or every 5 seconds.
Mm-hmm.
So with the support of Warm Store, we are providing customers unlimited free queries.
Okay. Yeah, so initially, Time Series Insight was more designed about getting historical data and analyzing that historical data with a lot of data and combining data from different sources. What you're telling me now is that we're definitely looking at having Time Series Insight also used for dashboarding and real-time visualization or near real-time visualization of IoT data, right?
Exactly, yes.
Awesome. How about we look at how it's looking like into the portal and on the websites?
Sure. So as you can see, you must be familiar with this user interface. This is Azure Portal.
Mm-hmm.
And you can go and start provisioning a new resource.
Okay.
So here I'm going to select Time Series Insights. And this is something that customers are already aware of, whoever is provisioning. So now I'm going to select pay as you go.
Okay.
And here is the new
So that's
section.
The only SKU that supports Warm Storage?
That is correct.
Okay,
yes. So we support it in pay as you go SKU.
Got it.
And as you can see now, everything else remains the same as we have in our current public preview.
Okay.
But in refresh, what we have added is, as you can see, there's a section of Warm Store here.
Okay.
And here you can enable. And now as soon as you enable, you can actually see your data retention, which kind of varies from 7 to all the way to 31 days.
Okay.
By the way, this experience is for when you're creating a new environment.
Mm-hmm.
But if you have an existing one,
and
you go in Portal, you can actually see that you would see this option of adding a Warm Store to your existing environment.
Oh, you can enable it after it's been deployed. Got it. Okay,
yes.
Great. Love it.
So once you have provisioned a Warm Store, you can actually go to your Explorer and you can start seeing the Explorer Warm Store data in there.
Okay.
So I can show you that.
Let's see that, definitely.
So here you would see, you'd start to see this orange line here.
Okay.
And this is showing you that it has, this data is coming from Warm Store.
Got it, okay.
Yes, and you can actually, define your time duration, and it will start to show you different data points. More importantly, I want to show you this, which is pretty cool, is that if as you widen your time duration, like you change your search span, this there's a backend call that is being made, which is getting your data from both cold store and warm store.
Oh, and combines it. And in Explorer, you don't see the difference.
Exactly.
Okay.
So, but here you can at least see this orange line. It would represent what's the data that is coming from warm store, and what's the search span that you could, if you just want to make a call through warm store.
Makes sense. And if we had a device actually injecting data in real time, we would actually see data coming along, right?
Yes.
Okay. And would it be the same type of visualization using the JavaScript control that we have for the web APIs?
Yes.
Okay. So similar things, if you're actually implementing your own UI, feeding in data from TSI, you would actually see real-time data in there.
Yes. In the API, we have a store type called warm store or store type called cold store.
Okay.
Yes.
Awesome.
Yes.
That's great. First, that's the first big one that people were waiting for. You told me, actually, that that makes a difference for how people are paying for it, right? So you were mentioning the fact that previously you were paying for TSI when it comes to cold storage by query. And now we're talking about paying by data and not query, so that you can do the real-time query to visualize data in real-time, right?
Exactly, which is why it's recommended that add warm store when for your dashboarding scenarios where you're querying a lot of more recent data. So your data size is not as much, but then you're querying it to know the status, like manufacturing plants, their health sensor health status, those kind of scenarios.
Much needed.
Yes.
Awesome. So the second type of updates were about the UX enhancements. So let's go through some of the biggest changes in the UX right now.
Yes, so we, with public preview refresh, we have also added a lot of cool features in our Explorer. Mm-hmm. So I will start with
your three favorite ones.
Three favorite ones, okay. I'll start with, as you can see, the time picker, right? And here you can, customers were asking for, they didn't want to go and add the data dates there.
Okay.
So now they have an option of selecting.
Okay, a time span, like last something.
Exactly.
Love it. Okay.
And then we have also introduced some enhancements here in the search, as you can see. So here, let's say, by the way, this is our building 121 campus data.
Okay.
That's coming in live.
This is real data from real building, from real campus.
Yes.
Got it.
So let's say I'm looking for room temperature, and it would show me both list view and then hierarchy view.
Oh, nice. Okay.
And let's say I'm only interested in...
I think it's good to remind people that TSI will actually allow for creating models for data that allows you to have this hierarchy view of the data set.
Yes, this is our hierarchy view. We have introduced improvements in hierarchy view, enhancements for UX in hierarchy view as well. Mm-hmm. I'm going to show that to you in a minute.
Okay.
We have also introduced, as you can see, this explorations. Here you can actually see that you can have a time shift to 1 hour earlier. Mm-hmm. It's very useful in the scenarios where you know there's a processing lag when you start to see the data.
Yeah.
So let's say you always know that there's a processing lag of 30 minutes or 1 hour.
Okay.
And so what you can do is you can add that here, and when you apply that, that's how your series your data starts. That's what the data shows you.
Got it.
Another thing that we have added is, like in the settings, you have support for stepped interpolation. We have min-max shadows that already exist, and then we also support time shift here.
Got it. Nice. And everything actually is like instant.
Everything is instant, yes.
Really impressive.
And here, actually, I just want to remove one, and I want to show you something else.
They keep coming, new features. Love it.
So let's say, as you can see, you know, here you can have a stacked
view of the,
Yeah, you have a stacked view here where each one is at its own lane.
Okay.
Then you can have shared view.
Okay.
And then you have an overlap view.
Okay.
And basically, overlap is when you want to see your data points in at time intervals. As you can see, it does not matter what the amplitude is here. Mm-hmm. It could vary. It could be very different in these two series.
Yeah.
But you can, for an overlap scenario, you can see that it's you can see how they are superimposing.
Got it. Okay.
Yes, by default, stack does what we show.
Yep.
OK, and then another one is you can zoom in, and you can see. And then you can zoom out for more details.
Okay.
You can also pick the chart that makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
So we support heat map and scatter plot. I think Rahul and Deepak from my team have already talked about these features.
Yeah, we already talked about the scatter plot and the various features like that. But still, they're coming so fast, all these features in TSI, that it's always good to refresh people's minds. So we were talking about data modeling in TSI as well. And you were telling me earlier on that we have new features as well in the Explorer when it comes to the hierarchy view and the various modelings for data.
Yes. So I'll show you, we have changed our experience a little bit for adding types, as you can see, in hierarchies and adding those. The workflow is still very similar to what it is right now, but it's more eye-pleasing.
Okay.
Yes.
And I guess it's more intuitive, it's more practical to use.
Yes.
Yep.
So let's say if you add a type, it's exactly the same experience, but it's just more cohesive and it looks better.
Okay. So Shipra, all good features in that new UX. You taught me about something called discrete variables. I have no idea what that is. So can you please enlighten me and explain to me what that is and how it shows up in Time Series Insights?
Sure. It's very interesting. And I'll give you an example. Many times, customers have this ask of, they're sending data, which is actually a state of their sensors.
Okay.
And what they are interested in is, let's say, if it's zero, which is off, it's red versus green, and similar kind of scenarios.
Mm-hmm.
That's what we call discrete variables. And we have we have added that support. So in Explorer, you can actually go and
love it. So it's no longer about telemetry with actual values. You can actually now have states. I get it. OK.
Yes. So I'll give you an example. I've created one here.
OK.
These are called categorical variables. Yes, as you can see, that it has label and it has values.
OK.
And you can create based on, you can add as many as depending on what your scenario requires.
Okay.
We support up to 100 states here.
I like it. Okay. So good and bad and anything in between.
Anything between. Yeah, there are a lot of scenarios where customers have been asking for it. So finally, we are adding the support. Yes.
Nice. So you have the type here. And then in terms of visualization, how does that show up?
So let's say the one that you're seeing here is I can move this, so you can see like green is all good. So you'd see the sensor 6 is showing you good, bad, and
nice. And you can obviously in the UI configure which color is which and so forth.
Yeah, and this is interesting because as you can see that when I'm looking at the visualization of these categorical variables, I'm more interested in what was the state of the sensor in a given time period, which is why you're seeing that when you hover over it, you would be able to see that.
Awesome. Love it. Last but not least, so when it comes to IoT scenarios, one thing that you like to do is to export data from the IoT context to business applications. And one tool of choice there to create dashboards and visualization that combine data from different sources is Power BI.
Yes.
And now we can export data from Time Series Insights to Power BI with a connector?
Yes, we are very excited to showcase that to you. We have gotten a lot of times customers have been asking us for this connector because there are a lot of scenarios in which they have this data from TSI and they want to combine it with some other data source and they want to do some deep analytics and exploration there.
Yeah.
So as you can see here, you'd see more actions on Explorer.
Mm-hmm.
When you click on it, you would see this.
Connect to Power BI. Love it.
Yes. And then you can actually copy it.
Mm-hmm.
And then you can go and you can actually say get data. go to more. This, what you see here is already loaded up, but okay. I'm just walking you through how customers would be able to connect. So you go to Azure, and you'd see time series and sites.
Nice, okay.
And then when you say connect, and in my previous screen, you saw that I had copied a query there. Yep. So I'm just going to paste it here.
Okay.
And then I'm going to say OK, and it's going to connect. It's going to load that up. And then you can just add your different data sources here, mm-hmm. and then you can explore.
So basically, it generated a data set for Power BI that it can now integrate into your Power BI dashboards
exactly.
and others.
Exactly. Yes.
Straightforward. I love it. Thanks, Shipra. So that's a lot of features that you just talked about, right?
Yes, we are very excited about it, and we want people to try it out.
Awesome. So if you guys want to learn more about TSI and the latest features, you can go to aka.ms/IoTshow/TSI, like Time Series Insights. Mm-hmm. Shipra, it was great to have you on the show. I hope you're going to come back.
Thank you. Thanks, Olivia.
Thanks for watching the IoT Show. See you soon.